And now, a rereading of Waluigi's Taco Stand, completely rewritten by Yoshizilla-Rhedosaurus on fanfiction.net. Chapter 1. Waluigi sighed in annoyance as he shook his head, not a single customer in sight. And despite being in the extremely popular Seaside Hill, the tall, lanky, purple, mustachioed man had yet to see anyone pop up.
You think I would get at least someone?
Waluigi commented, folding his arms.
Maybe putting it at the southernmost part of Seaside Hill wasn't smart.
Waluigi looked back, spotting the wonderful view of the green grass on the orange checkerboard hills, then turning to the front to see the beautiful view of the sandy beach and the waves.
Sure, I have a great view, but come on, who's gonna want tacos here?
Waluigi asked himself, placing both of hands on his face. Princess Daisy farted a deep-pitched, bassy tuba poot as she suddenly popped out of nowhere, as cheerful as a cute kitten or adorable puppy, wearing her usual yellow dress as she greeted herself with her infamous catchphrase,
Hi, I'm Daisy!
Go away, Gassy!
Waluigi muttered angrily in annoyance as he pulled down his purple cap in frustration, knowing how much of a pest the tomboy princess from Sarasa Land could be at times. Daisy placed both of her shoulders on the white-colored cart.
Come on, Waluigi! My boy! Why can't I have a taco? I can't enjoy a good spicy meal for breakfast, lunch, or dinner!
Waluigi pushed Daisy off.
You just want it so you can fart more.
Daisy giggled as she pointed at herself.
Well, duh! Gotta keep my cute pootsy-wootsy figure!
She let out a cute little poot, squealing like a young girl as she clapped her hands together.
Come on, let me have a taco!
No!
Waluigi remarked.
Please?
Daisy pleaded, holding her hands together. Waluigi turned around, slamming his hands on the cart.
Daisy, how many times do I have to?
Toadette handed Waluigi a $10 bill. Waluigi and Daisy were shocked to see Toadette, who just literally popped up out of nowhere. Waluigi's confused look turned into a grin as he snatched the $10 bill, placing it into his front right overalls pocket and giving Toadette 10 tacos. Daisy gasped, realizing how cheap the tacos were.
Only a dollar for a taco?
She dashed away, returning with a large yellow briefcase.
Shut up and take all my life savings!
Waluigi blinked as he was flooded by a mountain of green dollar bills. Daisy took as many tacos as she could, gleefully giggling as she ate them one by one in one gulp. Toadette watched, deciding to munch down on the tacos she had as well. Waluigi popped his head out of the money pill, smiling as he pulled out his arms.
Maybe this taco stand wasn't a bad idea after all,
Waluigi commented as he chuckled.
If it makes business like this, I can't afford to lose.
Daisy farted loudly, her butt facing Waluigi. Waluigi's purple cap was blasted away by the gusty fart, with Waluigi twitching his right eye. Daisy slightly blushed as she giggled.
Oh my, excuse me.
Daisy apologized as she giggled, munching down on the tacos again as she let out another loud fart. Toadette giggled, laughing at Waluigi's reaction as she fell over on her back on the smooth grass.
It's gonna be one of those stories!
Toadette added as she placed her hands on her face, smiling. Waluigi narrowed his eyes, groaning as he shook his head.
On second thought, I'll have to deal with this madness.
Dry Bowser and Petey Piranha both watched from the bright blue sea, turning to each other as they witnessed what had just occurred.
I have the feeling that we're going to be involved a lot more in this story.
Dry Bowser remarked to Petey.
Yeah, I guess so.
Petey mumbled in agreement as the two heavyweight characters kept swimming in the calm waters surrounding Seaside Hill, knowing what this predicament would ultimately lead to.
Holy fucking hell, Daisy! Stop freaking farting already, we get it!
Waluigi exclaimed. But alas, the flatulent tomboy princess kept on pooting away, since it was clear as day that tooting was her priority.
I'm glad that I don't have to put up with her, Pikachu!
Pikachu said to Space Ghost as they were observing this on the sandy beach nearby within the sand.
Yeah, my cohorts are annoying enough, but this is a whole lever above that.
Space Ghost responded as he had his arms folded, his yellow cape blowing by the combined natural wind and Daisy's farting.
Oh, it's no use trying to get sense to Daisy,
Silver the Hedgehog explained as he was doing another pizza delivery, dressed in his Pizza Hut gear.
Indeed. The chances of Waluigi succeeding in spite of this seem to constantly shift,
Rob added, the robotic operation buddy realizing that this might not end up the way the tall, lanky purple man of Twisted Evil may wish for it to settle. Popo and Nana both laughed as the ice climbers watched alongside the others, taking enjoyment of this as they knew that they had another way of messing with Waluigi, who already realized how much of a pain these two could be from his experiences as an assist trophy. Meanwhile, a bunch of high-quality characters were nearby on the other part of the beach, ready to get in on the action themselves as they were about to yabba-dabba-do-it-to-it and have a gay old time.
Hehehehe! Looks like this tall Yankee man is not holding back the business! Fred Flintstone exclaimed as he was feeling grand, Dad.
I just wonder, is he a real taco maker?
Robbie Rotten added as he did weird cartoony hand motions. Tito Dick Dickman Baby smiled as he held up his pants.
Oh, let's not get excited yet. The fun has yet to begin.
Toshu Nozomi farted as she pointed at herself, squealing with charming joy.
Tata Kitty!
Holy crap, Lois! Peter Griffin exclaimed as he was there for no reason at all, placing his hands on his head.
This reminds me of the time I had a cameo in a famous fanfic.
Everyone then looked at the Family Guy oddly, wondering if this was just another of his many funny moments. Dr. Hoshi and Pempy Ankylosaurus were walking on the beach, seeing the memes gathered together as the original characters looked at each other, the dinosaurs feeling out of place.
I think Yoshizilla did it again,
Dr. Hoshi exclaimed as the purple raptor in the white lab coat adjusted his light blue glasses.
What makes you say that?
Pepe sarcastically quipped as the yellow Ankylosaurus pulled out some lettuce he had with him and began munching on it.
Wait, screw you guys! I get the last word! Waluigi gets the last word! Wah!
Waluigi angrily snapped as he pulled out a Waluigi launcher, proceeding to blast everyone with copies of himself because overall the story was about one thing. Tacos being sold by Waluigi. Chapter 2. Waluigi sighed as the farting Princess Daisy skipped along in her sports outfit, the flatulent red-headed tomboy princess of Sarasaland popping back up at his taco stand in the ever-so-tropical seaside hill. Waluigi pulled out some normal tacos, folding his arms.
Oh joy, it's you again, Daisy!
Waluigi moaned sarcastically, adjusting his purple cap as he knew he would have to do this same song and dance for an enormous number of chapters from this point onward.
All right, how much dough do you got on you? And make it quick.
Daisy giggled as she pulled out three green dollar bills right from her gassy butt.
Will this do?
She asked as she blinked several times. Waluigi rolled his eyes as he snatched the money, giving Daisy three tacos in return as he was quick to pull out a flower spray and get the scent of Daisy's fart off of the dollars.
Hope, enjoy it. You're becoming my most common customer.
Daisy already munched down into her second taco.
Well, I love tacos. They're so spicy yet neat, and the after effects are great.
Daisy raised her right leg, letting out a raunchy toot as she placed her leg back down, giggling as she grabbed the third taco and munched down. Waluigi shook his head as he folded his lanky arms again, closing his eyes.
You're one of a kind, Daisy.
Okay, why do you let her pass gas all the time here?
Tito Dick Dickman Baby asked Waluigi as he was adjusting his jeans. Waluigi took a bite into a taco as he shrugged.
Because there's not much cause to panic or celebrate. We're all just pixels. Or dust in the wind, however you like to spin it.
He finished up his taco as he then dusted off his shoes.
Sometimes you have to ask yourself if being in fanfiction matters. Whether it's a one-shot or a relatively short story or a long story. Doesn't matter how long it takes to churn out, the end results are all the same.
Tito Dick looked on in amazement as he didn't have anything to say, with Waluigi deciding to relax as Daisy kept farting away. Waluigi often thought if there really was a purpose to be in a big story for you all to read, pondering if anyone would really take the time out of their schedule to sit down and read more than 100 chapters about a lanky weirdo like him running a stand of tacos. Waluigi was situated in the burning landmass that was the Grumble Volcano, having just raced a scorching race at the molten field of fire as he noticed a clone of him standing at his taco stand wearing black overalls. Dry Bowser, Toadette, and Petey Piranha pulled up in their different vehicles as they were a bit confused by the Waluigi clone, with Dry Bowser riding an ATV, Toadette riding a bike, and Petey within a cart.
So, excuse me for being rude, Wooly, but what's with the clone?
Toadette asked innocently while brushing back her pink pigtails with both of her hands. Waluigi shrugged casually as he shook his head, his eyes lowered.
Eh, I had him here in my place to sell tacos while we were all racing, he exclaimed.
Dry Bowser rubbed his bony chin with his left skeletal hand, after brushing back his red hair with his right hand, being curious about this odd predicament.
So you have him in your place to keep the stand active when you want to do something else?
Basically, yeah. What's the big deal?
Waluigi remarked as he pulled out a toothpick and began cleaning his teeth with it. Petey mumbled as he tilted his bulbous head, wondering if this predicament was a good idea to be preaching for as he felt his yellow petals tilt downwards.
"Please, he'll be fine. He's just a clone, remember?"
Waluigi pointed out as he stretched his long, skinny arms in the air.
"It's not like I have much to do, you know,"
the Waluigi clone responded to the group as he adjusted his cloned purple cap, with the others shrugging as they resumed their race around the volcanic race course, leaving the Waluigi clone to sell tacos to the tourists visiting the burning landmass. Chapter 3. Waluigi played around with some tacos that he made while being in the sunny seaside hill, sighing as he looked up to see Daisy again.
"You just don't quit, do you?"
Daisy giggled, her hands behind her back innocently, to ting as usual.
"I certainly don't. Now about them tacos."
Waluigi folded his arms.
"Which do you want, the regular beefy ones or a variety of them?"
He pulled out from behind his back.
"This one has shrimp in it."
Daisy covered her mouth with both of her hands.
"You have tacos with different kind of meat in them?"
Waluigi rolled his right hand.
"Well..."
Daisy snatched the shrimp-filled taco, stuffing it in her mouth as she belched loudly in Waluigi's face. Waluigi opened his eyes, only to be knocked down by a mountain of green dollar bills.
"More! I gotta have more shrimp!"
Daisy shouted, her eyes turning different colors as she giggled uncontrollably. Waluigi poked his head through the mountain of green dollar bills, chuckling.
"Oh, sure thing, Daisy."
Waluigi was in the shining Isle Delfino, being at the sandy beach in the Delfino Plaza as he was juggling the various tacos, with the piantas watching in curiosity as Dry Bowser was surfing on the waves in front of the beach.
"Ah, I love this place. I should have come here earlier,"
Waluigi exclaimed as he chucked in several tacos into his mouth, wrapping his arms around the back of his head.
"This is the perfect complement to Seaside Hill."
"I'd watch it if I were you,"
Dry Bowser spoke as he was riding around on his black-colored surfboard, keeping his balance as he adjusted his skull.
"Too much tropical goodness can tend to make you a bit fruity."
"I don't need you to tell me what to do,"
Waluigi snapped as he fired a taco at Dry Bowser with a slingshot, causing the skeletal reptile to lose balance and fall into the water as he and the piantas walking around on the streets all laughed at this occurrence. Chapter 4. Waluigi watched as Daisy munched down on the regular beefy tacos in front of his stall, grabbing more of them in her reach. Daisy farted loudly as much as she gobbled down the tacos, much to Waluigi's annoyance.
"Am I ever gonna get a regular aside from this butt blaster?"
Waluigi asked as he looked up at the clear blue skies. Toadette skipped up to Waluigi.
"You could get some advertising, then maybe people would notice you."
Waluigi turned to Toadette, narrowing his eyes.
"You honestly think people would want to come to a taco stand owned by me?"
Toadette placed her hands behind her back.
"Golly, well!"
Daisy burped and farted at the same time, turning over to Waluigi, waving both of her hands.
"My gassiness demands more tacos, old lanky one!"
She belted another poop. Waluigi sighed, patting Toadette on the head.
"Why don't you be a good scout and help me out on this? I gotta satisfy Fartina over here."
Toadette giggled uncontrollably, placing her hands on her face as she closed her eyes from laughing too much.
"Fartina! Ha ha ha!"
She sighed, nodding as she blew a kiss to Waluigi.
"Of course, big inverted L!"
She then headed eastward. Waluigi sighed, wrapping both of his arms around his head.
"This may turn out to help me after all."
Chapter 5. Waluigi sighed as he watched Daisy eat more of the different flavored tacos in front of him at his taco stand on the sandy shore of the Cheap Cheap Beach by the tropical jungle and wooden boardwalk. He approached Daisy, asking her as he placed his left hand on his hip,
"Excuse me for asking, Daisy."
Daisy farted loudly, opening her eyes as she winked while giggling.
"Excuse me for farting, Waluigi."
Waluigi rolled his eyes.
"Whatever, look."
He waved his arms about.
"I know I have no excuse to ask since I'm in the same boat, but..."
He took in a breath of air.
"Have you been in any games other than sports or parties?"
Daisy looked up at the clear blue sky, shrugging as she belted a low-pitched fart.
"Nope, I stick to them and stay out of platformers because I would be yet another damsel in distress in the platformers."
Waluigi folded his arms as he nodded.
"Good to know."
Waluigi was with Lilligant in Seaside Hill, Seaside Square, the two having their stands next to each other as several egg ponds were coming for the tacos and lemonade, with Whimsicott providing free lemons for them to take home.
"Let me ask you something,"
Waluigi started as he twisted his mustache, munching on one of the tacos he had just finished preparing.
"Why did you decide to have your stand right by me?"
"What do you mean?
Lilligant commented as she was preparing fresh lemonade.
We're fellow stand owners. We can't have our stands be anywhere in Seaside Hill.
Well, that's true, but it feels like this is out of laziness or done as an attempt at making jokes.
Waluigi commented as he adjusted his purple cap.
I mean, what reason do we have to be right by each other?
Well, often we're across the street from each other. Other times we're in the most farthest reaches of this tropical beach from each other.
Lilligant pinpointed as she shrugged, her flower head sprouting spores.
It never hurts to have some variety.
Yeah, she raises a good point.
Whimsicott added as she turned to Waluigi, holding a barrel of lemons in her stubby arms.
And why are you just giving away lemons?
Waluigi questioned as he squinted.
Hey, give me a break!
Whimsicott sighed as she glared at Waluigi, handing the lemons to the egg pawns.
I don't ask you how to live your life!
Chapter 6. It was the evening in Seaside Hill. Waluigi watched as Toadette skipped over to him and his taco stand. He sighed, turning to face Toadette.
Hey, Det, was there any success on the commercial?
Waluigi asked as he moved his hands around. Toadette waved her hands at Waluigi.
No, silly, the commercial didn't air yet!
She placed her hands on her hips.
Speaking of which, when did you do a commercial?
Waluigi placed his right hand on his face.
Last night, I got some of the guys from Pizza Hut to help.
Toadette held her hands together.
I hope it's funny!
So, how did that commercial of yours go?
Dry Bowser asked Waluigi, the skeletal reptile having his skeletal arms folded together, with it now officially being nighttime in Seaside Hill.
Oh, you know. Okay.
Waluigi remarked as he held a regular taco in his left hand.
Feeling a bit worried since it's my first commercial. Do you ever get this feeling?
Dry Bowser meekly shrugged as he shook his head.
Not really. I've been around for years and years, you know.
Waluigi sighed as he placed his hands on his face, shaking his head.
Wow, you're no help at all.
Chapter 7. Waluigi had a small television screen placed behind his taco stand where he could watch it. Princess Daisy, Toadette, Dry Bowser, and Petey Piranha were also there, both of the girls munching on shrimp tacos, with Daisy farting as usual, much to Dry Bowser's annoyance, with Petey and Toadette not really caring either way.
Alright, quiet your big fat butt down, Daisy!
Waluigi started as he snapped his fingers, pointing at the television screen with his right hand.
The commercial's starting!
Daisy let out one more brown stain-making poot as she then stayed quiet, allowing the commercial to play without any interruptions.
Boy, I sure am hungry, Silver the Hedgehog commented as he rubbed his stomach. I sure could go for something beefy on this wonderful beach. Waluigi popped his head out from the nearby palm tree on the left. Well then why don't you come down to Waluigi's taco stand? He jumped out of the palm tree holding different tacos. We have the classic beefy tacos, as well as the shrimp taco, a chicken taco, fish taco, and more. Even the choco taco, Victor the Crocodile asked as he wrapped his green arm around Waluigi. Waluigi laughed, nodding back to Victor. Yes, and we also have vanilla taco for those innocent ones out there. He posed, with Vector and Silva also posing. So come to Waluigi's taco stand and enjoy your tacos today. Waluigi, Vector, and Silva all sang together. Waluigi's taco stand, come spend your money here.
This is totally not a ripoff of the Krusty Krab commercial,
Dry Bowser sarcastically stated as he rolled his right skeletal hand around, his left hand on his skeletal hip as Petey chuckled. Toadette giggled and squealed with glee, being higher pitched than normal as she clapped her hands together quickly.
That was the best 60 seconds of my life!
Waluigi placed his arms behind the back of his head.
I really hope this does wonders for me.
Daisy laughed as she ribbed Waluigi.
Don't worry, Wally, you'll always have me.
She lifted her butt from the left, letting out a wet fart, then turned raunchy, placing it back down as a cute little poot was heard. She giggled and hugged Waluigi. Waluigi sighed as he rolled his eyes, still annoyed by Daisy's gassiness, with Toadette continuing to giggle and Petey continuing to chuckle, as Dry Bowser simply shook his head, wondering why he was spending his time with these idiots. You know what, I'm gonna skip ahead a little bit here, actually. There we go. Chapter 566.
When will this run stop?
Toju Nozomi asked as she and Fred Flintstone were under an umbrella together in the very drenched Seaside Hill. With there being a rainstorm as they were right by Waluigi's taco stand, which was covered up from the thunderstorm as several Waluigi clones were helping to keep the taco stand in place.
I don't know, but I yabba dabba do know this. You shouldn't go out in such hard weather,
Fred suggested as he sneezed several times to the tune of his own theme song.
Epic Flintstones.
Waluigi yawned as he placed several hot tacos into different brown bags as he was getting ready to have two of his copies deliver them.
No, really, what is it with your main theme following you everywhere?
Fred glared at Waluigi. What, you're just jealous that you don't have anything as grand?
That's not what I meant.
Waluigi growled as he was making another taco, using bacon and fish ingredients.
I'm just saying that maybe you shouldn't bring up that song so often. It gets old.
Nozomi playfully stuck out her tongue as she let out a wet fart.
Lucky you do, Granddad!
Fred laughed alongside the giggling Nozomi as Waluigi fumed angrily, snapping his fingers as one of the lookalikes grabbed a purple tennis racket and began smashing the two meme characters with it, the rain pouring harder as the storm got darker. Chapter 567. Waluigi was trying to make his beloved tacos in Seaside Hill as he saw Bowser laughing, the reptile holding the infamous super crown that has been going around the world in these strange new times of the future. Being a fellow meme himself, Waluigi ate a fish-flavored taco as he folded his lanky arms together.
So, what are you gonna do with that crown?
Waluigi asked. Bowser scoffed.
What do you think, String Bean? I'm gonna turn myself into the princess.
But you're already a higher royalty than her.
I just want to be a pretty girl, okay?
Waluigi raised his hands in defense as Bowser placed the super crown onto his head, transforming the turtle dragon ox dinosaur Keiju into what looked like Peach but with the Koopa King's features on, laughing as she was now a her, as opposed to what Bowser used to be.
Oh yeah, this is happening!
Bowsette bellowed while breathing fire from her mouth, approaching Waluigi as she placed her hands on the taco cart.
Now then, let me have those tacos so I can fire them out at me without it being awkward!
Can I try out that crown?
Waluigi insisted while raising his right index finger.
No way, loser!
Bowsette remarked while rolling her eyes.
No, I mean, do you have a spare?
Oh, yeah, sure, knock yourself out!
Bowsette huffed as she pulled out a super crown from her green spiky shell, handing it over to Waluigi. Waluigi placed the meme-infused crown of magical girl transformation onto his head, with it resting on his purple cap. He began to glow light. And then nothing happened, with Bowsette laughing as Waluigi blushed. And the reason it didn't happen? Because Waluigi is already a perfect princess. And that's the end. This has been a reading from Waluigi's Taco Stand by Yoshizilla-Rhedosaurus on fanfiction.net.